Welcome back, and it is Monday. Happy Monday.
Yes, it is.
And this could be the most beautiful sight you will see all week, or maybe even more than that.
Oh, you mean, oh, not you. Oh.
You're sweet. Okay. You're too nice. All right, I'll pay you later. All right, you really have to be in the right place, though, to see this butterfly migration. It's going to
yes.
be amazing.
So in today's Metroparks Monday, naturalist Jen Brumfield joining us now
Jen!
With more on some of the best spots to see clusters of monarchs. They're heading on their journey. And I got to tell you, Jen, we were watching you during the commercial on the big board here. And when you were told you had 5 minutes to talk, you lit up.
You did.
Because I know you're so excited to tell
I'm
us
so
about
excited.
The butterfly.
You're amazing, Jen,
I know,
first of all.
We
love
so
you.
Excited.
You need your own TV show. Definitely.
All right, I'll pop in.
All right, you got to do it.
We got to
do it.
So tell us about the monarchs.
All right, so what is happening right now, folks, beyond amazing temperatures in September, we're starting to get these north winds that are coming down across Lake Erie. Those are moving down through Canada, down through the Upper Peninsula, down through Lake Superior, on their way down through Lake Erie. That is bringing tens of thousands of migrant birds, bats, and insects. And the one insect that everybody adores is a monarch butterfly. There are thousands upon thousands of monarch butterflies on their way to Mexico, and we in Cleveland are one of their prime stopover sites. So this view right here, imagine on these warm days with north winds coming across Lake Erie that is pushing thousands of monarch butterflies over the lake and to our coastline, where they will rest and refuel here before they go to Mexico.
How long do they take here? What's the typical stop for them?
Oh, they'll stay here for at least a couple of days. Sometimes if the weather is a little rough, they will have to stay here for a week or so. But the key thing is that they want to be on their way as quickly as possible. It takes them about 2 months to get to Mexico, and they're going to a very specific overwintering site in the middle of central Mexico. It's called the Oyamel Fir Forest. And in this fir forest, millions of monarchs overwinter together socially in clumps and trees. So we get a tiny peek of what that actually looks like when they pass over Lake Erie, land on our shores. They will nectar on tons and tons of native wildflowers here. And in the evenings, they roost together in small clumps. Now, I looked for clumps this morning to see if we could find dozens or hundreds of butterflies, but those have already passed on their way heading south.
Okay.
Unfortunately, they don't always wait for us. They have to keep moving.
So is there a better time of day for people to go and see things early in the morning, midday, dusk?
That's a great question. Yeah, so a lot of people, in fact, we've got some people that are 4 or 5 hours away who have been waiting for us to predict one of the big movements of monarchs so they could drive up and see these hundreds of thousands of butterflies. Now, they typically leave Canada around 9 or 10 a.m., and it takes them a little while to get over the lake. And then ultimately, they will get here in the early afternoon, late afternoon. Ideally, what we want are some fronts to come in, some rain, maybe some colder temperatures. That will drop those monarchs. Doesn't hurt them, but it'll drop those monarchs in clumps along our shore. They'll go to those roosts. I'm actually going to grab a monarch right now because I went and caught one so that we could see one up close. So I've got the delicately, I'm leaning down here. You're going to see me disappear. I'm getting this monarch. I caught this one this morning. This is a very fresh female monarch. I'm going to bring it back up to the camera. There we go. So you can zoom in on that. This one individual, what's mind-blowing is that this one individual is going to, over the next 2 months, make 3,000-mile flight down to central Mexico, where it'll go to those Oyamel fir forests with the rest of the monarchs. These high-powered butterflies are able to use those winds, and the crazy thing is that they can navigate using the position of the sun in the sky. So they know at all times which direction they are headed. They follow geographic formations, but they also are able to use an internal compass in the tiny little antenna that they have coming off of their head to know which way they are going. It's absolutely mind-blowing.
It is. That's fascinating.
Hey, Jen, we got to wrap up.
Yeah,
I'd love
crazy.
To talk to you
here,
for
I'm
a half hour here.
I'm going to spread this monarch's wings very gently. Sorry if I'm talking
Don't
over you. I'm just
him.
So pumped.
No, I know.
Okay.
But
yeah, let's keep yammering.
Well,
right,
we got to get going, unfortunately.
Spread this monarch's
wow.
wings.
Yeah.
So you can see the colorations. This is a female, and we know that it's a female based on the hind wings here. The lower wings do not have a dark spot on one of the dark veins, all right?
Oh,
so
wow.
I'm holding this butterfly very gently. A butterfly's wings are covered in thousands of tiny little scales. All right, those little scales help propel them. They help keep their wings sturdy. They help with the color. These monarchs are remarkable here. We're gonna let this one go. I'm using like the lightest possible. You got that on camera? Hold on. All right, so she's just resting there for a second. She doesn't know what to do. We'll give her, there she goes. Did you get that? It was so fast. But these monarchs, they're caterpillars, which I'm going to get right now.
Thank you, Jen. Hey, I want to let everybody know, best monarch butterfly viewing, we're told, Wendy Park, Huntington Reservation, and the Wildwood Villa Angela area. And we have some rain coming in on Wednesday, Scott said, so hopefully that'll be a good time. Jen, we'd love to talk for a half hour.
But
we got to move.
Is it over already?
Yeah. It's been,
oh my gosh.
It's been 6 minutes,
it's
my
okay.
producer.
Get that monarch caterpillar.
But I want more of Jen.
I know.
It's so great. Okay, so that's the guy.
That's
huh?
awesome. Thank you, Jen.
Absolutely. We will update on Cleveland Metroparks Facebook page.
Okay.
Watch our Facebook page.
For the
awesome.
Time. Right? We will
yes.
for sure.
Know when the monarchs are coming.
You got it. Thanks.
You're amazing.
She's the best.
She is so amazing.
I hate to cut her off because it's a...
I've never been so excited about a butterfly. Anytime she talks about something, I am so excited about it.
Because she has such a passion for it.
She does, and she educates you so much. I mean, when you see a butterfly, you have no idea all the things about them.
Like, now we know that's a female.
She is amazing.
Hey, Scott, so the rain that's coming in Wednesday, that might knock some of these butterflies down, right?
Yeah, I tell you what, if we do get some thunderstorms, and I think we will, that could definitely pose a problem.